Hey, everybody. Good evening, if it's evening for you, or good afternoon, or good morning. It's good to be with you. What holds your heart? What stirs your soul? What matters come to mind? The cares you keep, the thoughts you think, it's not a wasted time. Seeking you will find. Joy still comes in the morning. Hope still walks with the hurting. If you're still alive and breathing, praise the Lord. Don't stop dancing and dreaming. Still good news worth repeating. So lift your head and keep singing. Praise the Lord. The years roll by. Wonder why we lost our way from home. A father finds a child inside. We left for growing old. Awake, 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 my soul. Joy still comes in the morning. Hope still walks with the hurting. If you're still alive and breathing, praise the Lord. Don't stop dancing and dreaming. Still good news worth repeating. So lift your head and keep singing. Praise the Lord. Let everything, let everything, let everything praise the Lord. Guess I should explain this song a little bit. I wrote it with a friend of mine named Ellie Limebear in January of last year. And I was going through a lot of anxiety at the time, and stress, just worries about the future. And I remember the night before I went for a walk with my daughter and I said, hey, Daddy's going to write a song tomorrow. What she write about? And she said, everything. And I thought of Psalm 150 and how it says, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. So we wrote the song not knowing the events that would transpire in the world a year and a half later. But I think there are certain things that just remain that are true. And joy still comes every morning, the joy of the love of God. And so I wanted to sing about that over my life to remind myself that there's things that are true that don't change, even when there's so much uncertainty. Let everything, let everything, let everything praise the Lord. In the working, in the waiting, let it praise the Lord. In the blessing, in the breaking, come on, praise the Lord. In the dying, the rising, let it praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Joy still comes in the morning. Hope still walks with the hurting. If you're still alive and breathing, praise the Lord. Don't stop dancing and dreaming. Still good news worth repeating. to lift your head and keep singing, praise the Lord. Hey, bud, what's going on? You just want to hang out? All right, my son's going to join me while I keep singing. This song is it's based on the Beatitudes. You're not alone if you're lonely. When you feel afraid, you're not the only. Bye, Connor. We are the same. In need of mercy, to be forgiven and be free. It's all you got to lean on, but thank God it's all you need. And all the people said amen. Oh, and all the people said amen. Give thanks to the Lord, for his love never ends. And all the people said amen. If you're rich or poor, well, it don't matter. Weak or strong, you know love is what we're after. We're all broken, but we're all in this together. God knows we stumble and fall. And he's the love the world, he sent his son to save us all. And all the people said amen. Oh, and all the people said amen. Give thanks to the Lord for his love neighbor here. And all the people said amen. Blessed are the poor in spirit who are torn apart. Blessed are the persecuted and the pure at heart. Blessed are the people hungry for another start. For oh, this is the kingdom of God. And all the people said amen. Whoa, whoa, whoa. And all the people said amen. Give thanks to the Lord for his love never ends. And all the people said amen. Yeah. And all the people said amen. Whoa, 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 whoa. And all the people said amen. Give thanks to the Lord for his love never ends. And all the people said amen. And all the people said amen. Woo! Those are revolutionary words that Jesus spoke 2,000 years ago when he said things like, if you're poor, you're blessed. And he said, the meek shall inherit the earth. Here's another revolutionary idea. He demonstrated. It's a song about grace. Great is your faithfulness, O God. You wrestle with the sinner's restless heart. You lead us by still waters and to mercy. And nothing can keep us apart. So remember your people, remember your children, remember your promise, oh God. 'Cause your grace is enough, your grace is enough. Your grace is enough for me. For me. Great is your love and justice, God of Jacob. You use the weak to lead the strong. You lead us in the song of your salvation. And all your people sing along. So remember your people, remember your children, remember your promise, oh God. Your grace is enough, your grace is enough, your grace is enough for me. Yeah, your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough for me. Oh, remember your people. Remember your children. Remember your promise, oh God. I think that's why a lot of the songs I write are inspired by Scripture. Because I believe Scripture does an amazing job of conveying things that are true. Things that are eternally true and things that are true about humanity, about who we are. And, you know, when you sing... Augustine said singing is like praying twice. And so I write things that, I try to write things that are true. And so that I can sing the truth over my life. And not just things that are like theologically true, but emotions that are true, that are honest. Because I think honesty is a big, it's a pretty important part about prayer. Being honest with God, being honest with yourself. But an amazing thing happens when we sing things that are true, regardless of whether or not we kind of feel it in a moment. It has the ability to reconnect what we know and what we feel. Because sometimes those things get disconnected. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough for me. God, I see your grace is enough. Heaven reaches down to earth. Your grace. And we're back. Sorry, quick guitar change. This is a 12-string guitar. It's kind of made popular in a lot of folk music. Some of you may have seen one in a church. Some of you may have grandparents who played one in a church. I did not break into a convent to steal this. I actually own this. It has such a distinct sound, and one of the things I love to do through my music is to try to find sounds and phrases and things that have a sense of history. Because I love how when things that have history, when we hear them, when we see them, when we step into them, they do something. They tether us to the ground a little bit more. They kind of make us feel rooted. So I'm going to play a couple songs on this. So I'm going to play a couple new songs. So I had a new album come out called Alive and Breathing. It came out the beginning of March. I was on a tour. We did one weekend of shows, and then that was it. But it was fun getting to play this song. This is the last song I wrote for the album. Some songs I write because I'll read something, or something will come to me in prayer or in worship, singing. I could be at Mass and, you know, I'll hear a reading, or, you know, a different prayer will get, you know, uttered, and it strikes a chord in me and kind of sends me off on a wild goose chase trying to figure out what God is saying. Some songs just come through playing the guitar around my house, and then I'm walking around my house muttering things, and my family has to put up with it. So that's how this one started. It's called Joyful Noise. Come on, everybody, looking for the way. Come on, everybody, looking for the way. Kingdom is a-coming, and no one is forgotten. We're crying out in Jesus' name. People come together, I know there's a way. This is the start. We're singing a brand new song. Lift up your heart. Worship the Lord our God. He is the champion of heaven. Healer of the broken. Stand up. Rejoice. Make a joyful noise if you know his voice. Make a joyful noise. Jesus overcoming all the distance we make. Jesus overcoming all the distance we make. Fill us with your kindness and lead us to repentance. For such a time as this we pray. People come together, I know there's a way. This is the start. We're singing a brand new song. Lift up your heart. Worship the Lord our God. He is the champion of heaven. Healer of the broken. Stand up. Rejoice. Make a joyful noise if you know his voice. Make a joyful noise. Love is a battleground. Praise is laying my weapons down. My hands up to heaven now. Make a joyful noise. My heart had to hit the floor to find all I'm longing for. 'Cause I know you're so much more than a joyful noise. Love is a battleground. I'm laying my weapons down. My hands up to heaven now, make a joyful noise. My heart had to hit the floor to find all I'm longing for. 'Cause I know you're so much more. This is the start. We're singing a brand new song. Lift up your heart. Worship the Lord our God. Is the champion of heaven, healer of the broken. Stand up, rejoice, make a joyful noise
This is the start. We're singing a brand new song. Lift up your heart. Worship the Lord our God. He is the champion of heaven. Healer of the broken. Stand up. Rejoice. Make a joyful noise. If you know his voice, make a joyful noise. Make a joyful noise.
Woo, man. I'll tell you one thing quarantine has not helped with is the ability to play long stretches of music, because I haven't done that. I got done with this tour, and my kids were on midterm break, and then we were homeschooling parents, which is not something that my wife and I signed up for. We've been married 10 years this year, by the way, which is, you know, a great way to spend a 10-year wedding anniversary. We had to finish out the school year distance learning, which, let's give it up for all our educators, by the way. You know, one of the things that I look back on this time that we haven't even really talked about is that our entire education system got upended overnight. And so many teachers and parents, principals, like, people had to just totally about face and change how they did everything. And students had to adapt to it. If you're a high school student watching this, or a college student, all of a sudden you found you're like done for the semester, or congratulations, you graduated. It's just a really weird time. And my wife and I have tried to kind of maintain some semblance of normalcy and to keep things kind of chilled. Like earlier on, my 8-year-old just kind of walked in here. And before, I think I probably would have been like, what are you doing? I'm filming a concert. And now I've just learned, well, you know, he's 8 and he's surviving a pandemic. So let's just keep it all in stride. And I think that's what faith requires of us. I think faith, more and more in my life, I'm realizing that faith requires us, especially as followers of Jesus, to be a lot more flexible about the world that we live in and the plans that we have. This next song I wrote last summer. The thing about praying for revival, or praying for change, or praying for God to move, or praying for a new Pentecost, the transformation of society, is that when God shines a light, it shines everywhere. And for me, I feel like in some ways that's what this quarantine has been. I've been watching God shine a light on my life. But that includes my heart. And it reveals my limitations, my biases, the areas in my life where maybe I haven't let God enter into more. I think especially as a husband, especially as a father in this time. So this song's been a special song for me. I think particularly as a reminder that even when we find ourselves passing through difficult places, that we hold on to the things that are really important. And we know and trust that Jesus is lighting our steps. But as he lights our steps, we also recognize that he exposes in us the things that need to change. The song's called Light the Way.
There's a song of resurrection, hope that fills the weary soul. You have made your home inside. I'm not alone. In the shadow of the valley, your word a lamp when I can't see. May I not forget the promise leading me. You're leading me. You light the way. You light the way. With a fire by night and a cloud by day. You light the way. We are pilgrims on a journey, hungry for what lies beyond. Strangers once now made a family, we belong. We are tellers of a story, of word made flesh and kingdom come. Sinners, saints, and hope of glory, Christ alone. Oh, Christ alone. You light the way. You light the way. With a fire by night and a cloud by day. You light the way. You're lighting up my future. You're lighting up my faith. You're lighting up my wonder with endless grace. You're lighting up my failure. You're lighting up my fear. Everything I've carried over all these years. You light the way. You light the way. And a cloud by day. You light the way. You light the way. Where you go, I'll go. Where you stay, I'll stay. You light the way. You light the way. With a fire by night and a cloud by day. You light the way. You light the way. You light the way. You light the way. Lighting up my future. You're lighting up my faith. You're lighting up my wonder with endless grace. You're lighting up my failures. You're lighting up my fears. Everything I've carried over all these years.
You are the light of the world, Jesus says. I guess in order to be light, you have to let it shine on you first. We all agree that the world feels broken right now, feels hurting. But we seem to have so many disagreements about how to bring about restoration or reconciliation. And maybe the first thing the followers of Jesus could do, one of the first things, is to demonstrate what it looks like to need God. To not have all the answers, but to demonstrate a need for the one who is the answer. And in doing so, modeling a deep sense of humility, Lord, I come, I confess, bowing here, I find my rest. Without you, I fall apart. You're the one that guides my heart. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one defense, my righteousness. Oh, God, how I need you. Sin runs deep, your grace is more, but grace is found, is where you are, and where you are, Lord, I am free, holiness is Christ in me. Temptation comes my way. When I cannot stand, I'll fall on you. Jesus, you're my hope and stay. Of your faith, oh wanderer, come home. You're not too far. So lay down your hurt, lay down your heart, and come as you are. Come as you are. Rest in his arms. Amen. It's good to be with you. You know, this is a really weird scenario for me. I think one of the reasons why I got into touring and why I love doing it so much is being able to play music in front of people. And one of the strangest things about this season has been, no offense, but doing stuff like this, because it's just not something that was on my radar for what, you know, life would look like. But then again, it wasn't on anyone's radar. So, you know, when I was asked to be part of, you know, Light the World, and just to kind of share some songs and share some stories, I was thinking a lot about just my own life and kind of the story of how I came to faith. And so I thought I'd maybe kind of share, because it's 25 years ago this year that the 2020 is a big year in a lot of ways. But for me personally, it's my wife and I's 10-year wedding anniversary. And it's also 25 years since I moved from Canada to the United States. And I started going back to church. I had stopped going for a couple of years, kind of drifted away in middle school. And I didn't really know a lot about my faith, honestly. I kind of daydreamed my way through religion class, through catechism. And I remember moving here and being 20 years old, and I never doubted the existence of God. I always believed in God. What I tell people was that I didn't know that he believed in me. So I had a cousin my age, God bless her. She invited me to go to a church with her, and so I ended up at a mass that was on Sunday nights. It was kind of geared towards teenagers and their families, and it was through a ministry called Life Teen, and I don't remember the homily, no offense, priests. I don't remember the music. I remember the musician had a really awesome mullet. But I remember that everyone sang and participated. And there was something about the witness of watching people sing horribly out of tune. But they were willing to do it because of their belief. That because of their faith, it was worth singing. And that was very, very moving, I think, to me. And it gave me permission. That was in July of 1995. And that following November, I was on a youth retreat and had a really powerful conversion experience. And really that weekend, I kind of gave my heart to Christ. I just said, like, you can do whatever you want. And what I've learned 25 years later is that that kind of surrender, it can't happen just once. It has to happen daily. Because it's easy to surrender your finances when you're a college student and you don't have any money. It's another thing when you're older. It's easy to surrender your idea of marriage when you're single. It's harder to do that when you're actually married and you're trying to live out your sanctity. What I've realized is that the human heart is a million kingdoms. And left alone to my own devices, they'll all have their own rulers. So I need Jesus to be Lord of every part of my life. And that's what inspired this song, which I wrote last year. It's called Lord of My Life.
Sky without a north star, a ship without an anchor, caught up in the current, my heart is prone to wander. All the roads I've taken lead me back to nowhere. You're the destination, and you're the way to get there. You can have it all. Be the song I sing, be my guiding light. Savior of my soul, be the Lord of my life. Every step I take, always by my side. I am yours and you are mine. Be the Lord of my life. Just keeps growing. This is all I want. I surrender all. Be the song I sing, be my guiding light. Savior of my soul, be the Lord of my life. Every step I take, always by my side. I am yours and you are mine. Be the Lord of my life. Oh, 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 oh. Break on through. I want to go where you go. I want to move where you move. Want to love who you love. Watch it break on through. I want to go where you go. I want to move where you move. Want to love who you love. Watch it break on through. I want to go where you go. I want to move where you move. Watch it break on through. Break on through. Oh, 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 oh. Mine, be the Lord of my life. I am yours and you are mine. Be the Lord of my life.
Yeah. Surrender is common. It's a common thing that we're all called to. You can't escape it. But I think it looks different as the passage of time and the movement of life happens. And right now, one of the hardest things I remember for me to surrender in my 20s was just the thought that I knew everything. At least about my life. Just the ability to say, God, I don't even know if I fully know myself. So many of the mystics, I feel like when you look at their writings, that's a big part of it, is that it's their willingness to spend time with God that opens up the avenues and pathways of their own heart that helps them know themselves more fully. Because that's the thing, is that I'll never know myself fully without knowing Christ, because it's only through Christ that I could ever really know myself. And it's so obvious to me, especially now being married and having kids, of knowing, you know, what it takes to be a good dad or a good husband. You know, it's been 10 years and it just feels like it's gone like this. And I'm grasping for for my kids to just like slow down, stop growing up so fast. But they're their own person, and I'm just called to steward, be a steward of their life. You know, there's this element of surrender that I wasn't even, when I was surrendering my heart to Christ, I wasn't even thinking about that. That I can't keep my kids from growing up. And I can't even fully protect them in this world. And the thought that I can, it's just a silly illusion. I'll do everything I can. I'll lay down my life. And there's this element of how time moves and how you can't stop it as much as you want. So the only thing you can really do, and this is what's so great about the kingdom of God, when Jesus starts talking about the kingdom of God in the scriptures, is that ultimately the kingdom of God is about being in the present moment. Jesus says the kingdom of God is at hand, meaning it's literally, it's almost like it's set your fingertips. You could grab it. And it's funny because I think a lot of us spend a ton of our time in the past. What if I would have said this? What if I would have done this? Would things be different? Man, I did that so much. We worry about the future. You know, we think about the future. You know, am I going to get the grades? Am I going to get an internship? Am I going to do postgraduate studies? Am I going to get the job I want? Are they going to say yes if I ask them out on a date? Whatever it is. We spend so much time worrying about the future or regretting the past. And we're never really present in the moment. And that's where Christ is waiting to be found. So I have memories that still are so precious to me. Holding my oldest son in one hand and today watching him ride a skateboard for the first time. And living in the tension of that, of realizing that this is all going so fast, and at the same time, the best thing I can do is not to worry about that, but it's just to be in the present moment. And maybe that's one of the things that this quarantine and this this time is, maybe that's one of the things that God's doing through it. He didn't need it to do it, but he's redeeming the time. I believe that with all my heart, that God is always trying to redeem the time. And so in this time, maybe you and I can try to be a little bit more present to the moment that we're in, the now. Jesus said, sufficient for a day is its own evil. So we be present to the moment now and try to find Christ in our circumstances. And when we're in that moment with him, it really doesn't get any better. This song's called As Good As It Gets.
Joy that would come without warning. Open your eyes, woke you up on a Saturday morning. I remember running outside to a world with no fear, with wide open spaces and summers that lasted for I remember it clear. But these days what I feel is a longing all too real. But you take my eyes off of the future. You lead my heart out of the past. You are the promise. Here in the moment where I find my rest, you are as good as it gets. There have been days that I wish would be over, no margin to give just the strength to roll over. I remember thinking that all my best days were behind me. Tomorrow would come rushing in like some kind of prince charming. I remember it. These days what I feel in the struggle, you are real. But you take my eyes off of the future. You lead my heart out of the past. You are the promise here in the moment where I find my rest. You are as good as it gets. You make it easy, yeah. You make it easy. You are the promise here in the moment where I find my rest. This is as good as it gets. This is as good as it gets.
I sing that all, also just knowing the tension of being able to sing about being in the presence of God, being satisfied with it in the midst of so much hurt. And you know, I sang a little bit ago, I sang Lord, I Need You in another song. It's kind of a newer song. That I think talks about in some ways the same heart. It's a newer song that I wrote last year. I think it's kind of based on the revelation that God is a Father who loves you deeply, immensely. You know, so many people, I remember being in my college years and being so frustrated because I had no clue what God's will was for my life, and I didn't know what that was supposed to be. And I remember a priest friend of mine said, Matt, God's will is simple: be holy. So do whatever it takes to be holy, if that matters. Make your sanctity the highest priority of your life, and then, you know, make appropriate decisions around that. And it reminds me a lot of the quote from Augustine, who just said, love God and do what you like. When we're able to make our heart for Jesus and keeping our heart receptive to Jesus, it's amazing how much everything else can kind of fall into place. And Jesus says, if you've seen me, you've seen the Father. And so as we run to God tonight with our concerns, our fears, our worries, our joys and our sorrows, we also realize that he's run to us. All the space between us and him, he's occupied in the person of Christ, which is good news tonight. So this song's called Run to the Father. I've carried a burden for too long on my own. I wasn't created
to bear it alone. I hear your invitation to let it all go. I see it now, I'm laying it down. I know that I need you. I've run to the Father, full end of grace. I'm done with the hiding, the reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again and again. Oh, oh, oh. You saw my condition, had a plan from the start. Your son for redemption, the price for my heart. I don't have a context for that kind of love. I don't understand, I can't comprehend. All I know is I need you. I've run to the Father, full end of grace. I'm done with the hiding, no reason to wait. My heart needs a surgeon, my soul needs a friend. So I run to the Father again and again and again and again. Oh, 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 and again and again. My soul needs a friend, so I run to the Father again and again. I run to the Father, I fall into grace. I'm done with the hiding, no reason to wait. My heart found a surgeon, my soul found a friend, so I run to the Father again and again. Again and again. Oh, 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 and again and again. Oh, 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 and again and again. Surely my God is strength of my soul. Your love defends me. Your love defends me. And when I feel like I'm all alone, your love defends me. Your love defends me. Yeah. You are my joy, you are my song, you are the will the one I'm drawing from. You are my refuge, my whole life long. Where else would I go? Surely my God is the strength of my soul. Your love defends me. Your love defends me. And when I feel like I'm all alone, your love defends me. Your love defends me. Yeah. Day after day, night after night, I will remember you're with me in this fight. Although the battle, it rages on, the war is already won. I know the war is already won. Surely my God is the strength of my soul. Your love defends me. Your love defends me. And when I feel like I'm all alone, your love defends me. Your love defends me. We sing hallelujah. You're my portion, my salvation. Hallelujah. Surely my God is the strength of my soul. Your love defends me. Your love defends me. And when I feel like I'm all alone, your love defends me. Your love defends me. Surely my God is the strength of my soul. Your love defends me. Your love defends me. And when I feel like I'm all alone, your love defends me. Your love defends me. We sing hallelujah. You're my portion, my salvation. I believe in the risen one. I believe I overcome by the power of his blood. Amen. All amen. I'm alive. I'm alive because he lives. Amen. All amid, let my soul join the wood that never ends, because he lives. I was dead in the grave. I was covered in sin and shame. I heard mercy call my name. He rolled the stone away. Amen. All amen. I'm alive. I'm alive because he lives. all of it. Let my soul join the one that never ends. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, every fear is gone. I know he owns my life, my future in his hands. Amen. Oh, amen. I'm alive, I'm alive because he lives. Amen, amen. Let my soul join the wood that never ends, because he lives. Because he lives.
Amen. I don't have a job. Don't pay your bills. Won't buy you a home in the Washington Hills. Won't fix your life in 5 easy steps. Ain't the law of the land or the government. But it's all you need.
Before I sing this chorus, I just want to say thank you to Catholic University of America for having me. I wrote this song 11 years ago on a Southwest napkin, on an empty flight in the middle of a recession. And I just share that because I think we live in times right now where some of you have a boldness. And God wants you to follow that boldness and have the audacity to write prayers and live lives that are like prayers that share the hope of Jesus in this time. And as you do that, maybe hopefully we share the heart of Christ, which is a heart of solidarity with the least among us, for those that suffer.
And love will hold us together, make us a shelter, weather the storm, and I'll be my brother's keeper, so the whole world will know that we're not alone. It's waiting for you, knocking out your door. Heart is the floor, and you're on your knees, and love will hold us together, make us a shelter to weather the storm, and I'll be my brother's keeper, so the whole world will know that we're not alone. This is the first day of the rest of your life. This is the first day of the rest of your life. See, even in the dark, you can still see the light. It's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. This is the first day of the rest of your life. This is the first day of the rest of your life. 'Cause even in the dark, you can still see the light. It's gonna
gonna be alright. Oh, and love will hold us together, make us a shelter to weather the storm. And I'll be my brother's keeper, so the whole world will know that we're not alone. God bless you all. Thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of your conference. We'll see you soon, hopefully.